It was early Sunday morning. It seemed like weeks since I had stood at the cross and watched Jesus die. As I headed to the tomb to anoint the body of my Lord, my mind raced with memories. Not only had Jesus freed me from my own demons, but I had watched him deliver so many people from their own miseries. He had not only healed and cured others, but more importantly, he had transformed lives by his compelling message of love and grace. Now it seemed all of this had been for nothing. When I arrived at the tomb, I found that the stone had been rolled away. I ran to Peter and John. "They have taken the Lord's body out of the tomb, and I don't know where they have put him." They ran to the tomb, confirming my words. Then they returned to the others to tell them. As I stood outside the tomb, weeping, a man I thought to be the gardener approached me. "Why are you crying?" he asked. "Sir," I responded, "if you have taken Jesus away, please tell me where you have placed him." "Mary," he gently replied. That was all he needed to say. It was as if the scales from my eyes had been instantly removed. Any questions, any doubts that I had were gone. I knew this was Jesus, the living Christ, standing before me. The exhilaration in my spirit propelled me back to the disciples. "He is alive! Jesus is risen from the dead! I have seen him! Praise be to God! Jesus is alive!"
Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Dear friends, it is my honor, it is my joy and privilege to wish you a blessed Easter morning. How much I wish that we could be together, worshiping and singing and praying and celebrating this day within our sanctuaries. And yet I also know, and I trust, that no matter where we are, that God is indeed with us, and that God's presence unites us. That is the resurrection. And so let us begin this time together by turning to God in prayer. Let us pray. God of mercy, we no longer look for Jesus among the dead. For he is alive and has become the Lord of life. Increase in our minds and hearts the risen life we share with Christ, and help us to grow as your people toward the fullness of eternal life with you. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and with the Holy Spirit, one God, both now and forever. Let us take some time to dwell in God's promises now fulfilled, as found in Holy Scripture.
Then Peter began to speak to them. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. How he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses, and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name.
A reading from Holy Scripture, Matthew chapter 28, verses 1 to 10. After the Sabbath at the dawn on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. There was a violent earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven and, going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men. Then the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. For I know you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here. He has risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples he has risen from the dead and is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him. Now I have told you. So the women hurried away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy, and ran to tell the disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them. Greetings, he said. They came to him, clasped his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me. The word of the Lord.
We just heard Margie read these words from Matthew's gospel. She said, As the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. In John's gospel, it says, Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark. Luke says, Very early in the morning. And still Mark's gospel tells us, Very early on Sunday morning, just at sunrise. Let these words sit with you for a while. Let them stir your hearts. Because there is an incredible detail contained within the opening verses of the resurrection story that is so often overlooked. In these words, we are reminded that even before the day had dawned, God was already speaking light into the darkness of the world's tombs. That even before the night had faded, God had already started to wipe the tears of those whose hearts had been broken. That even before the sleep had fully lifted from their eyes, God was already making sure that hope was awaiting those early first visitors. And that even before the moon had given way to the light of a new day, God had already pierced the veil and raised God's Son to new and to glorious and to joy-filled life. My goodness, what a timely reminder that is. Earlier this week, I found myself walking with Holly and Nate through the apple trees on our property. All day long, I had been completely overwhelmed, as perhaps you have also found yourselves overwhelmed, with reports of medical supply shortages and travel restriction, not to mention mounting COVID case numbers. My heart was heavy. My mind was occupied. When all of a sudden, my 5-year-old son, Nate, and with a level of exuberance that only a child can fully muster, proclaimed, "The trees are coming back to life." He had been watching and waiting for the buds to return. We had missed it. It had completely escaped Holly and my notice. But he was right. Upon closer inspection, the tiniest, most subtle cracks in the branches revealed the most welcomed and reassuring signs of new life. Even before the darkness had subsided, even before a new day had dawned, even before our eyes were ready to see it, even before we were allowed back into our church buildings. God was here. Hope had returned. Jesus is risen. You know, I believe that we are called to proclaim that same message with the same level of childlike exuberance to a world that stands waiting for the good news with the same urgency as it did thousands of years ago. We are also called to proclaim our God is awake. The Lord has risen. Life has returned. For in saying these things, we will continue to point out resurrection in the midst of struggle. We will continue to identify new life when all that seems visible is worry and fear. Name love into loneliness. Proclaim promise amidst doubt and witness to goodness for the sake of those who need to be reminded of it the most. This is the resurrection, as witnessed in the world all around us. This is God's new life, still stirring the souls of God's people. And this is the reason why we can proclaim
with the most profound, faith-filled certainty that Christ is risen. He is most certainly risen indeed. Blessed Easter, dear friends. The sun is awake. God is with us. Life has returned. You are loved. May our alleluias echo further and wider than ever before. For indeed, God has already been busy, and Christ is alive. Thanks be to God. Amen.
The Lord has made, let us rejoice and be glad in it. It is a gift, truly, when we are able to come together as one people in prayer, offering up the needs of the church, the world, and all of creation. Let us take some time now to quiet our hearts and to turn to God in prayer. God of resurrection, from the very beginning, you gave the church the gift of women as your witnesses, as preachers, teachers, and leaders. Open our ears to their proclamation this day and always. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. All your creation praises you. The earth hums, the seas pulse, the stars shine, and the galaxies whirl in glorious harmonies to honor you. Let us hear and blend our voices in the song. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. The countries of the world experience disunity and conflict. We set our minds on fear and greed rather than on your rule of justice and steadfast love. Build up all countries on your cornerstone of peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We still weep with those who weep, and mourn with those who mourn. Cradle the fearful, the suffering, and the dying, assuring them of your loving presence. We pray this morning for all those whose names we carry on our prayer lists, as well as those whose needs are known only to you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless the creative and service of those who lead worship this day in new ways. Be with those who seek you from television screens and internet streaming services. We ask that you be with us all as we celebrate this Easter and give thanks for your life-giving promises. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For our Bishops Michael and Susan, their assistants, and Pastor Kimber, our dean, for the joy we experience in our shared ministry. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Risen Lord, you went ahead of us into the grave and defeated the powers of death. We remember those who have died. Inspire us to live our lives in the resurrection hope and draw us to you in our final days. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. With bold confidence in your love, Almighty God, we place all for whom we pray into your loving care, asking all of this through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. Bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace. Amen. Alleluia. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Go and peace. Happy Easter.